Hey guys, how's it going? I hope you're doing really well. Today we're going to be looking at Garmin data screens. It's one of the best features on the Forerunner and the Fenix range, and one of the reasons why I absolutely love the Garmin watches. Basically, with the data screens, you can actually change the information that you're seeing on your watch while you're out running. You're not just stuck with those few metrics you think you are. So I'm going to show you how to change the ones on the watch and get them set up to how you want them to be and have the information that you want on the screen. I'm going to show you how to then go onto the Garmin Connect IQ store and download loads more data screens as well, including ones which will show you loads of information on the screen at the same times. Race pacers, how to put a map on there. Guys, stay tuned. This is going to be a great video. Hi guys, I'm Shanebow, and if you haven't already pressed subscribe, then please press subscribe. I make running and running tech videos designed to help you be a much better runner. So I really want to start this video by going straight into showing you how to set up the data screens that are already on your watch. So let's get straight into it. So we're going to press start and then start again. Now these are the normal three bits of information you're going to get, but we're going to add a fourth. If you've got the Garmin Forerunner 45 or 35 or lower, you're not going to be able to do what we're about to do. You can only just change the three bits that you've got there. So we're going to go up for options, and then we're going to go run settings, and then data screens, and then we're going to click the pencil just here, and then three fields, and then we're going to push it down to here. We've got four fields on here now, look. Press start again. What we can then do is select, we're going to take out laps because we're not interested in laps. What we're going to do instead is we're going to have an average pace field on there instead. So we could reorder it if we wanted to and move the data screen to a different place. We're going to keep it as it is. We're going to keep going back just here. And then if we go back into start and then run, there you have it. There are a couple of other data screens built into the watch, which I will also show you. So you go back to data screens and then keep pushing down until you get to this little plus, add new. And then what you've got run dynamics. That's for heart rate monitors, things like that, that you add separately. Virtual partner you can add. That will add a little running person on your watch face. And you can set the pace that little virtual partner runs at. And it'll tell you whether you're ahead or behind that virtual partner. Then you've got a map, if you wanted to add a map, which I'll show you in a second, and music controls. There's actually a separate video on my channel which really goes into detail on music controls. So you've got the map just here. So we'll just install the map just on here. And what this will do is it won't overlay road information, but it'll draw a squiggle of where you've been. So if you wanted to do a loop and come back to yourself, you could. Or if you want like a little trail or something, you want to be able to come back on yourself, you can do that with that screen just there. So what we're now going to do is go onto the Garmin Connect IQ store and look at some of the ones that you can download. So grab your phone ready. The first one we're going to look at is one of my favorites. It's called Peter's Race Pacer. And this is really great. You can say, for instance, say you're going to run a 10K or a marathon, and you can actually input your time that you want to complete it by. And what it's then going to do is it's going to monitor you, and it's going to tell you on the screen whether you're behind by a certain amount of time or ahead by a certain amount of time. And it's also going to give you some really key information while you're running. So let's get it on your watch. Grab your phone and go to the Garmin Connect app and swipe over from the left, and then go to the Connect IQ store, which is just down at the bottom, and then that'll load. Click the three lines on the top right, and then select data fields just here. And then you've got all these different data fields. There are absolutely loads of data fields to go for. So you've got a map one just here as well. I'm not gonna demonstrate the map one today, but if you're interested, let me know in the comments and I will do a map data screen video. So yeah, they just keep going on and on and on. So quite easy really. So if, say, for instance, there was one that we heard of that we wanted, so we go search just here. So we're going to go to race, and then we've got Peter's Race Pacer just here, look. So we're going to click on download, the little blue just there, and then click OK. So from there, click back, keep going back to the main menu. So if it doesn't already sync, just press the blue circle at the top and it'll then sync. It'll then come up on your watch when you go into data screens, and you can select it as an active data screen on your watch. So when it's synced to your watch, go start and then go back to options again, run settings, data screens, and then go down to the bottom just here. We're going to go to add new, go to custom data, and then you've got this one. We're just going to choose this single one, choose field one. You've got Connect IQ fields, so you can add two different ones from the Connect IQ store. So we're going to click start just there, and there you are. You've got Peter's race pacer, so you can just press start. And then you can maybe, if you wanted to put that right at the top, put that right at the top just there, press start, and there you are. So we're outside now. I've set up the Peter's Race Pacer data screen to be a 5K to be completed in 30 minutes. So I'll show you how to change some of the settings on the ones you download in just a few minutes. But let's take a look at what this looks like whilst you're running. So you can see at the top, you've got your average pace, and then underneath in green, you've got your HR rate, and then you've got pace, and then you've got the main bit just here. It's in red at the minute. We're behind by 5.5 minutes. If we were to get ahead, it would then turn green and it would show how far ahead we are, which is absolutely brilliant. So you can see at a glance on my red or green. You can see on this one, it says like it, donate. Some of them don't have a nag message. Some of them do. It's only usually a few dollars to get rid of that nag message if you wanted to, but you can obviously just leave it as well. Another data screen I really like is called All In One. And if you've got it set up properly, you've got everything on the screen that you'll ever need. You should never really need to press a button on your watch again until you finish the run. So let's take a look at that one whilst you're running. So the amount of information on this screen is awesome. You've got your heart rate, you've got your average pace, you've got your timer, you've got your distance, you've got a little compass at the bottom to show which way you're going as well. And obviously you can customize all that as well through the settings menu on your phone. It's a really, really great watch screen and a really great data field for you. One of the other great features on All In One is you can actually set it up to do an alarm for certain points that you choose to. So for instance, every 15 minutes, it could flash up and say drink, and it'll actually make a little tweeting noise. Or it could be that you're doing a big race and you want it to remind you that actually half an hour's gone past and you need to take a gel. I'll just quickly show you how that looks out on the road. So what we're now going to do is go in and change the settings on one of the data screens that we've installed. This is where it gets really, really cool. So swipe over from the left, go to Garmin Devices, select your watch, and then in the middle, you've got Activities, Apps and More. Click on that. Obviously go to data fields, and we've just installed Peter's Race Pacer. So we're going to go to that, and then at the bottom you've got settings. Click on that just there, and these are all the things that we can actually change on here. So you could, for instance, go in and select target pace, target speed, or even target finish time. If you were to do that, then you just click on the box underneath, and then you just change what your target pace was or your finish time just there. Once you've done that, just click on done at the top right, and then all you need to do from there is sync it back with your watch, and you're ready to go. Congratulations, you are now a data screen guru. So if you use any other data screens that I haven't mentioned, then please put them in the comments below, because that's really going to help some other people out. If you've got any questions as well, please just chuck them in below. I will do a follow-up video in the future on the top data screens that are available in the Connect IQ store. I've got some more videos for you coming up in just a second to choose from. But please, guys, check out my other videos. I've got a great library of videos now. I'd really appreciate if you did press subscribe. You're going to get some great videos, and it really, really helps me out grow this channel further. So thanks again for watching, and I really appreciate any comments you put below. Thank you very much.